Today, we're going to continue our Flash Basics series with Lesson 2. If you haven't watched Lesson 1 yet, what are you doing here? Go forth now and check out Lesson 1. Then, when you've done that, you can come back here. For the rest of you, Lesson 2 starts right now. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. Today we are continuing our Flash Basics for Fujifilm cameras with Lesson 2. We're picking up right where we left off with Lesson 1. By now you should have completed your homework assignment from Lesson 1. You shot a small object, used atmospheric lighting in the background, and you set your flash to TTL mode. At this point, you should be able to take a photo in TTL mode using a flash mounted to the camera, but without it looking like you took a photo using a flash. So in today's lesson, we are going to focus on manual mode and how the exposure triangle affects flash photography. So the very first thing we're going to do from now on is shoot with our flash in all manual mode. Now the basic process of setting the flash in manual mode is very easy. All of my demos today will be using the Godox TT685, but the basic principles can apply to any brand of flash that you use. You've been shooting in TTL mode thus far, and your flash shows you TTL in the upper left-hand corner. You see it right there? To put your flash in manual mode is simple. Go ahead and press the mode button. You see that right there? And it'll toggle between manual, TTL, and multi. Choose M for manual. By putting the flash in manual mode, we are preventing the camera from making any exposure adjustments to the flash other than what we choose to dial in ourselves using either aperture, shutter speed or ISO, or flash power. Now, flash exposure is like regular exposure where, you know, you're using your exposure triangle of aperture, ISO, and shutter speed, except now you have a fourth option to consider, the power output of your flash. So basically, you're no longer dealing with the exposure triangle, but rather an exposure square. Okay, so the flash is now in all manual mode, and it is at this point that we turn to the camera, specifically setting the exposure for our scene using ISO, aperture, and shutter speed. Now, like we did in the prior lesson, we always want to consider ambient light throughout the scene. In other words, what do things look like in the background, right, if you're not shooting with a flash? So you look through your camera and you look at the scene, you look at the background, and you focus on that first. And for today's demo, I'm going to take a self-portrait, okay, using a Fujifilm X-T3 camera with the Godox TT685 flash mounted right on top of the camera. We are not yet going to be getting into remote triggers. Those are coming soon in a future lesson. And I will be using this little remote control to take the shot. So regarding our exposure settings, let's start with ISO. When shooting with a flash, I recommend that you always start by setting your ISO to the lowest base ISO that you have. In the case of the Fujifilm X-T3 or the X-T4, that would be ISO 160. You see it right here? This will give you the least amount of noise in your image. So just leave it at the lowest base ISO for now. Next comes aperture and shutter speed, and they both affect your flash in very different ways. Aperture controls the exposure of your flash. In other words, how bright the flash appears in your scene, while shutter speed controls the exposure of the rest of the ambient light in your image. Remember that when you shoot with a flash, you are actually shooting with two different lighting setups at the same time in your scene. First, there's the light coming from the flash, right? Blasting into your main subject. And second, you have all of this background light in and around the back of your scene. So knowing this, let's now go to our aperture settings. If you use a wider aperture, such as f2, then your aperture's opening will be larger, more light is going to come in and enter through your lens, and thus your flash exposure is going to be brighter. Likewise, if you stop down your lens all the way to, say, f16, the aperture opening will be smaller, and this will let less light in, and thus your flash exposure will be darker. This is very similar to that other way of controlling the brightness of your flash in your scene, and that would be the flash output power. Obviously, you can control that by increasing or decreasing the power on your flash right on the unit itself, or you can do it with the camera in the flash menu area. Now, on the TT685, to adjust the flash power, that's really simple. rotate the little dial around the set button. You see that right there? And that will adjust the flash power in 1/3 of a stop increments. And you can also adjust the flash power right from the camera itself. Go into your flash menu, into flash function setting, and use the keys on the D-pad right here to put yourself right on this area that controls the flash output power. Once you have it highlighted in white, you see that? Now you can go ahead and rotate the rear command dial to change the values. And it does it in 1/3 stop increments. If you turn down the flash power to say 1/16th, then your flash exposure will be darker than if you had it at 1/2 power and so forth. So as a starting point, I recommend setting the flash power to maybe 1/2. So why is this so important? Does it really matter what method you choose? In other words, controlling the brightness of your flash by setting the aperture on the camera, or controlling the brightness of the flash by setting the power output on the unit itself. Yes, it does. And as a general rule of thumb, it is better to use the power controls on the flash to control the brightness of the scene than it is to use the aperture on your camera. As a general rule of thumb. Because if you use your aperture to control the exposure of your flash, then you may find yourself in situations where you have to set your aperture to say F16 in order to prevent your flash from being too bright. But you may not want F16. Remember that aperture also controls another key part of the artistic vision of your image, namely what's in focus in your scene. If you want that nice, you know, background blur and subject isolation, then you must use a wide open aperture like F2. And because of this, if you are using your aperture to control the exposure of your flash, that can be very limiting. So instead of aperture, you're going to control the exposure of your flash with only adjusting the power output of the flash unit itself. Now we're going to get to that in just a second. But for now, regarding your aperture settings, just choose an aperture that gives you the subject isolation that you're looking for. Now if you're not sure, then as a starting point, go ahead and set your aperture to f5.6. Now let's talk about shutter speed. Shutter speed has an even more interesting effect on your flash. Repeat after me. Shutter speed behaves differently when shooting with a flash. Shutter speed behaves differently when shooting with a flash. As long as you are shooting at or slower than the sync speed of your camera, your shutter speed has no control over the amount of light coming from your flash and hitting the camera sensor. So what is a camera flash sync speed? Well, have a look right here on the shutter speed dial. You see the one entry that has a little X next to it? You see it right there? 1/250th of a second. Now the fast and simple explanation for all of this is that 1/250th of a second is the fastest shutter speed that you can use and still avoid having black bands appear across your image. Anything faster and your image will look terrible. Let me show you what I mean. I'm gonna go ahead and put the flash unit right on the camera and turn it on, and I'm gonna shoot at the fastest sync shutter speed that my camera can handle. Okay, here we go. And as you can see from this rather overblown image, I did capture everything within the frame. Now let's try it at a faster shutter speed than the camera's sync speed. This time I'll crank it up to 1/1000th of a second. Okay, see that at 1/1000th of a second? Look at how you have the black band across the bottom of the picture, see that? So what are these black bands? Well, because your camera has a mechanical shutter, it uses two different shutter curtains traveling up and down across the sensor area. The sync speed is the fastest speed on your camera where that first curtain opens completely before that second curtain begins to close. Once you reach a fast enough shutter speed, and in the case of this X-T3, that's 1/250th of a second, and you go beyond that, there is never a moment when your sensor is completely exposed without being covered, at least in part, by at least the second curtain. I'm simplifying this a bit, and really the only thing that you really need to know for this lesson is that you cannot go beyond your camera's flash sync speed. Well, unless you're using a high-speed sync flash. We will get more into this topic in future videos, especially when we talk about using a remote trigger. I don't want to get bogged down too much by it here, but since you're all gathered around, let me show you something really cool. If you go into your camera's menu in the flash section right here, under flash function setting, and you go over to where it says sync, you see that right there? If you change it to auto FP high speed sync, check it out. Once you do that, you will notice that on your flash, you have this new icon. You see that right there, the little H? This has now put your flash into high speed sync mode. Keep in mind that not all flash units can do this. But now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna put the shutter speed to 1/2000th of a second, all right? Well past our flash sync speed. And I'll go ahead and take a shot. Have a look at this. There's no black banding because I had the flash in high speed sync mode. That is all we're gonna get into this right now. I just wanted you to be aware that this in fact exists, that you can go beyond what your camera says is the flash sync speed right here. Okay, now stop. You watching this video, stop what you're doing, especially if you are out there multitasking while I'm trying to teach this. Come over here right now, you and you, all of you, come over here and listen up because I'm about to teach you the single most important concept in all of flash photography. Are you ready for it? Here goes. Shutter speed controls the amount of ambient light in your scene. Not the amount of light from the flash, but the ambient background light around your scene. You might want to write this one down, okay? Aperture controls the flash exposure. Shutter speed controls the ambient exposure. Got that? And knowing this, you can begin to paint your background lighting, perhaps even color and glow, by slowing down your shutter speed. Let me show you exactly how this works. For this demo, I am setting my ISO to 160, my shutter speed to 1/60th of a second, and my aperture to f5.6. I'm gonna take this camera, I'm gonna put it on a tripod over there, aimed at me, and we are gonna shoot this together and adjust it, and I'm gonna show you how aperture and shutter speed affect your flash. Okay, looking through the viewfinder with these camera settings, the first thing you wanna look at is your background, and you wanna adjust your shutter speed to get that background looking like you want. So for example, right here, it looks a little bit dark to me. I want to see the lighting in the background a bit more in my scene, but I don't want to be blasted with the flash, okay? I'm also going to use this light right here just as something we can have as a reference point, all right? So this is our scene. There's a light here, and there's some ambient light in the background. So I wanna take a look through my viewfinder and adjust the shutter speed so my background is exposed how I like it. There, I think 1/25th of a second is roughly in the ballpark of what I want. Let's take a shot right now and see what it looks like. Oh my gosh, that is way too overexposed. You see how the flash is just blasting, right? Ugh, that looks terrible. Now, the way we're gonna fix this is we are going to reduce the power of the flash. We're not gonna adjust anything else on the camera. We're just gonna lower the power of the flash. And as I mentioned, you do that right here in the camera menu. You see that? Because it's so bright, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the flash power down all the way to 1/16th power. Okay, let's try it again. That's not bad, we're getting there, but it's still a little bit too much like I'm shooting with a flash. Let's now lower it down to 1/32nd power. Okay, that's not bad, but I would like it to be just a little bit less exposed. The problem is that we are now at the lowest power setting of the flash. We can't reduce the power anymore. And in this case, we now turn to our aperture. We're going to lower it a little bit. Remember, I said aperture controls the flash exposure as well. So we're going to now stop down our aperture to f7.1. Again, we're at 1/25th shutter speed at f7.1. Still a little bit more exposed than I want, so let's now drop it down to f9. Okay, so at f9, I'm okay with how the main subject is looking, but I would like the background to be a little brighter. And I'm gonna go ahead and drop the shutter speed to 1/8th of a second. And you see how it brings up the background lighting a little bit? Okay, that's not bad. Have a look at the shot we have now. Obviously, this is a simplistic setup here, but the idea is to show you that aperture controls how much flash power is on your subject, and you can do that by adjusting it, and that changing your shutter speed is what you do when you want to modify and paint in the background light. Now, something very important I need to tell you. This flash can actually go lower than 1/32nd power. It can go all the way down to 1/128th of a power. However, However, I wanted, for the purpose of this demo, to stop it at 1/32nd of a power and then explain what do you do if you've reached the limitation of the flash. And that is the point at which you must turn to your aperture. So, when would you use aperture? If your flash is not powerful enough for the amount of light that you need, then yeah, you might want to widen up your aperture to make it appear brighter in your scene. Likewise, you can do the reverse and adjust your aperture if your flash is too bright, even at the lowest power setting, and you want more ambient light in your scene. In both of these cases, adjusting the aperture is a good idea. Okay, your homework assignment for the next time is to first of all put your flash in manual mode like we did earlier on in the video. Next, I want you to try shooting a main subject, such as a portrait, but have background lighting going on, but also have another practical light, perhaps just off to the side, where you can catch some of the glow from that light. So I want you to go ahead and put your ISO in base ISO, put your aperture into something a little bit more on the open side, like f4 or f2, and start with a shutter speed of, say, 1/30th of a second. Then mount the flash on top of your camera and make sure again that that flash is in manual mode, and start with it at, say, 1/4 power. Then go ahead and take your first shot and then adjust your flash power from there until you get your main subject looking good. I want you to then shoot a series of images, but you are going to vary your shutter speed, and you're going to see the effect that it has on these practical lights in the background, particularly the light that you have near your subject. I want you to look for things like, is there increased saturation? Is there more of a glow? What effect does it have on the lighting in the background, particularly as you are lowering down your shutter speed? The whole purpose of this is to basically practice altering your shutter speed to paint in light and work in conjunction with the flash on your main subject. So shoot a few versions with different shutter speeds, and we'll pick this up in part 3. As I say in the beginning of these flash tutorials, this is not a sprint. It's a marathon. We are going to go slowly, and it is very important for you to understand how to put your flash into manual mode, how to use 4 elements of what I call the exposure square, right? And to factor in flash power, both in how it's affected by shutter speed as well as aperture, in particular with shutter speed, and that's what I want you to practice. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you found the video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will be signing off now, but I will see you in a brand new video next week. Take care.